The question from Senator Cruz, along with Senators Hawley and Graham, is for both sides, the counsel for the President and the House managers. Yesterday, Manager Demings refused to answer whether Joe Biden sought any legal advice concerning his conflict of interest on Burisma, the corrupt Ukrainian company that was paying his son, Hunter, $1 million per year. USA Today reported that, when asked about it, Vice President Biden said, excuse me, quote, he hadn't spoken to his son, Hunter Biden, about his overseas business, end quote. That account was contradicted by Hunter Biden, who told The New Yorker that he told his father about Burisma and, quote, Dad said, I hope you know what you're doing, and I said, I do. Why do Joe and Hunter Biden's stories conflict? Did the House ask either one that question? The White House counsel goes first.
You heard our answer, I'm sorry, Chief Justice, Senators. Senators, you heard our answer regarding that yesterday, but it is very interesting that he said he never spoke to his son about overseas dealings. His son said different things. Joe Biden was the point man for Ukraine, investigating, at the time, Ukrainians were a corrupt company, Burisma, and Zelchevsky, its owner, an oligarch who, by all media accounts we've discussed, was extremely corrupt. Hunter Biden is paid $83,000 a month to sit on that board with no experience in energy, no experience in the Ukraine, doesn't speak the language, and we clearly know that he had a very fancy job description, and he did none of those things. He attended one or two board meetings, one in Monaco, and then he went on a fishing trip with Joe Biden's family in Norway. The entire time, Joe Biden knows that this oligarch is corrupt. Everyone knows that. There are news reports everywhere. No one will dispute that. In fact, it raised eyebrows worldwide. But the Vice President, by his account, never once asked his son to leave the board. We wouldn't be sitting here if he did. He never asked his son to leave the board. Instead, he started investigating the prosecutor who was going after Burisma and this corrupt oligarch who they say was corrupt even by oligarch standards, who had fled the country, living in Monaco. He does not ask him to leave the board. He does the opposite. In 2015, what does he do? We know by reports he has close contact with President Poroshenko. He travels to Ukraine twice. He links the aid to the firing. Same thing in 2016 at a White House meeting. Links the aid to the firing of the prosecutor. Calls him four times in the 8 days up to leading to the prosecutor. The prosecutor investigating Hunter Biden, yet he never says that, all cases closed. Days before Biden leaves office, he jokes to Poroshenko that he may have to call him every couple weeks to check in. Hunter Biden stays on that board for 3 years. 3 years. Then we hear the video of Joe Biden bragging about firing the prosecutor, linking it to aid. Then we have the six-minute phone call.
Mr. Chief Justice.
The House managers have 2.5 minutes.
Mr. Chief Justice and to our senators. Senators, thank you so much for that question. I know you have asked about a conversation between a father and his son. And what I can tell you, probably like just about everybody in this chamber, there are probably some conversations that I can't repeat to you about my conversations with my son. So I don't know the answer to your question, Senator, what that exact conversation was. But what I can tell you is this. If we are serious about why we are here, and I have no reason to doubt that we are, if we are serious about seeking the truth because the truth matters, not just for those who have paid the price in our history to form a more perfect union and protect our democracy, but it's important for our future. And in this case, if we're serious about that, then I can tell you this, that we are serious then about hearing from fact witnesses. Looking at the Bidens, no matter how many times we called their name, we have no evidence to point to the fact that either Biden has anything at all to tell us about the president shaking down a foreign power to help him cheat in the next election. The precious election, trying to steal each individual in this country's vote. I don't believe either Biden has any information about that, but let me tell you who I think does. Maybe we should call Ambassador Bolton. If we're serious about the truth, maybe we should call him because we have a good idea about what he might say. Or what about Mr. Mulvaney, who had day-to-day contact with the principal in our investigation, the President of the United States? That's not good enough. Well, what about, the question was asked about when did we know, or when did the president first put the hole on? Well, we do have reports that say on June 19th of 2019, Mr. Blair personally instructed the director of OMB to hold up security assistance from Ukraine over a month before the infamous July 25th call. So
thank you, Mrs. Manager Demings.
Thank you, Mr. Chief Justice.